fix my chain real quick, real quick, real quick.
What you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm reppin'? I'm sitting my hood like they call me the black. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. At the way it get hectic, you don't make me slide up on you, no electric. You hit them like it's Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text it. Listen, I don't know why they mentioning beef. I don't think no one better than me. You would say what you want, but my steppers don't speak. If I tell them to go, then they stepping on three. Like, boy, the chain that's competitive. Me make it rain in your hood.
It's week 5 of the National Football League. And we'll see Chris Olave. And with him, any catch could be a big one. He's the NFL leader in touchdown receptions. It's the Vikings and the Eagles, and it comes your way next.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today we've got a Week 5 matchup in store here, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends. And now out comes Minnesota. Start this drive out on the ground. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Simply not much more you can ask out of your running back. Over 100 yards and the 3 touchdowns.
And for an old coot like me, I loved it because he did it on the ground. A running back taking control of the game. That's what I like to see.
Hold on, hold on. An old coot?
Coot, C-O-O-T.
All right, I'll look that up later. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. You look at this Eagle defense. They come into this one in the bottom half of the NFL against the run, number 19 overall.
And when people talk about facing a challenge, they are certainly getting one in this ball game because they're facing the number one rushing unit in the NFL, which means it's going to be a contest they've got to be prepared for from the first snap.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up.
Well, the Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
If they open things up, let's see what the defense does here too after a good stop. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 15 more yards there and quickly another first down.
And the Vikings first down.
Here's a give up the middle. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6. The Vikings are the perfect 4-0 to start the campaign. And they've been playing their best football of the year, winners of 4 in a row.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on.
And this is taken in at the 5. Touchdown, Vikings! Chris Olave. Halfway to 100 now with career touchdown number 50. And the Vikings are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Week after week, Charles, when we see this offense operate, I don't know, they just seem to get more impressive.
They certainly do, and let's face it, it's no surprise they're the best in the NFL in scoring. This team designs things well and executes even better. And here, it only takes a few snaps before they're in the end zone. That's how they demoralize teams. That's how they put them on notice.
They're
quarterback leading this offense back out. On the previous drive, he hooked up with Chris Olave for the touchdown. And now they'll try to do something like that again here, first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards. So that'll bring up second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Escaping the pressure right. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. That's a 3rd down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play.
Now that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on 3rd down, how about him buying some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open, and when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a 1st down.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Brings up 2nd and 9.
He'll drop to throw. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So a costly penalty yardage wise, as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
66 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this 1st half. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 2nd quarter, 14-7. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up 1st and goal. 1st and goal, Perkins. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. The Vikings in the hurry up. They're hustling up to the line. Back to Perkins on 2nd and goal. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. About a half yard from the end zone, 3rd and goal. Throw here, rolling to his right. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Chris Olave with touchdown number 15 of the year and 2nd of the game. And the Vikings are an extra point away from drawing level. In the 2nd quarter, and already his 2nd touchdown reception.
Absolutely the definition of a difference maker here in this 1st half. Clearly one of his quarterback's favorite targets in this game, and I figure he's going to draw a little more attention and coverage moving forward.
He notched his 15th touchdown pass of the year on that last drive, and they'll look to keep it going here, 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that, but that would have been a big play. But he could not pull it in. He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. He completes it to Olave. Now the Vikings will use the 2nd of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the 1st half. Back to throw now on first down. That's a lot of bringing in another one. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Again, he'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. Downfield, and he's got Olave. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. So we've
okay,
hit
Brandon,
halftime.
Thank you very much.
Just a field goal separating
just a bit.
These two teams
but first,
at
let's
the
get
break.
Everybody caught up as with what's going on
the
around
to
the NFL
for
here in Week 5.
At REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
We'll start up at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. And that one tied 14 apiece in the second quarter. From there, let's head up to Cincinnati, Ohio to check in on the Bengals at home at Paycor Stadium. And they have the lead over the visiting New York Jets. The Bengals looking to sew that one up, and they look to be in pretty good shape. Lastly, let's check in on our nation's capital to see what's happening.
Message. The Vikings offense set to go to work to begin this third quarter. Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Second and nine now. They'll roll him out right. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain.
He's been patient this entire game, waiting for the perfect moment to surprise him with a quarterback keeper. There he catches him off guard and converts his first rush of the game into a first down. Gotta love that efficiency.
This one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just a yard.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota.
Ball start, offense.
Yeah, maybe they were coming with a blitz that time and it caused a jump.
I think if we saw it, you know that they saw it. Might have been a little discussion down there. Bad guys coming, pick them up, pick them up. And someone jumped.
Now they'll change things around before the snap. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And this one nearly intercepted. Boy, that would have been a great time for their first pick. But instead, it's third down. They need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Eluding the pressure right. He lets it go deep for Olave. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Minnesota's offense takes over possession. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this one taken in by Olave. And he'll be knocked to the turf right there as he gets it up to the 43. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. It looks like a loss of right around 11 there on first down to set him back on second. They'll look to throw. Olave holds it in. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will finally be taken down. But how about that play? It's a big one. On the final act of the third quarter. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Chris Olave. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Vikings have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense because they're going to need to find some...
So all eyes on this Vikings offense. Down by six, 2 minutes, 30 seconds to play. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He lets it go deep for Olave. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
Oh, man, late in a tight ball game, every play so critical. You feel like you've got to find a way to come up with that football. That was put in a great spot, but it just didn't want to stick in his hands. That's a big letdown.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. You don't have to beg the Philly faithful to make noise. On their feet for third down. And it is caught. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now.
They'll look to throw again.
And oh, that one nearly intercepted. That would have sealed it. Instead, it'll be second down.
He's back to throw. Throwing it right here, caught by Olave. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 29-yard line. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Run flawless two-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
Back to throw. Tries the left side and finds Olave. Touchdown! Chris Olave, 29 yards. And the Vikings are an extra point away from taking the lead here in the fourth. Now they can boot it through on the always important extra point, and then their defense has to hold up their end of the bargain.
And there's something that you've pointed out in numerous games that we've worked. Okay, the excitement's going on. Everyone's celebrating over there. Who's calling up the defense to make sure they're focused because they still have some work to do?
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field.
And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that.
Like he'll throw here. He'll buy some time right. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Sliding out of the pocket. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
The Vikings ready to go again on offense.
And they've got this one at hand. No timeouts remaining defensively.
They go play action here on first down. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And incomplete as the clock stops here with just 1 second to go in this football game.
Here's second and 10.
On play action, they'll throw. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end, but now this game is over.
That was an excellent come-from-behind victory, Charles, especially there in the fourth quarter. Both offense and defense were clicking. They're going to feel good about this one.
Boy, are they ever, because the deficit they faced certainly wasn't small. They obviously did not give up on that one, and in the end, how about that come-from-behind victory? They'll cherish this one for a while.
So for the Vikings, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for...
off of nothing, my name is topic discussions. If I give them attention, they all would probably start blushing. So power and honey's the only thing that I'm crushing on. Bonafide, still on everything that I stepped on.
I can get it gone in the blink. We can make a from the same. He can make a call if you tweet. I can make a ball when I speak. Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty trying to come up on the band, cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash at?